first thought is superheroes and comic books like that from Marvel. But I have more of an eclectic taste in comic books, as you'll see. I've loved comic books ever since I was really little. I like them because it's really fun to see all the artwork, and it's light reading, but you get to use your imagination. It's in the video, Hailstorm in California. It was like a month or two ago, I think, that I vlogged it, but it's a fun video if you want to check it out. Okay, let's check out some comic books. Okay, here are some of the comic books I would share with you today. First one is The Sandman. It's by Neil Gaiman. I read some of The Sandman when I was in high school. I just love anything that Neil Gaiman writes that I've come across. I really loved his book, The Graveyard Book. Really different artwork. It was really outside the box, literally, where they don't do the just box style comic books. And you can see some nebula over here. It's really cool. Flowers. Over here, and yeah, the characters are just so extraordinary. Oh, that's like a cross section, and so it's just broken up into different frames. They've kind of just done a dissection of the ship that she's climbing through. Reading that in My Chemical Romance quote, I can't think of it right now. One of their songs, if one of you can remember it, let me know in the comments. It's like, it goes from, because I'm like black and white, very dull frame. Very surreal type of illustration. Oh yeah, this mature audience only for this book, but it's the internet. I think everybody's mature here. It's just gorgeous. I haven't read this one yet, so saving it for when I really need a good book to unwind to. And whenever I do, I know it's gonna be awesome. So that's the first one. And here, Saga. This one is $2.99. The Sandman is $3.99. They even go for less, too. They come for like a dollar, but they also come for more, too. These are kind of right in the middle. Boyfriend got me into these, and he was lending me all the ones up to here, so I am caught up on this one. It's a really great story. It's a love story between these two characters. This woman comes from a planet where there's all winged people, and the man comes from a planet where there's all with horns on their head, and they've been at war, so it's very Romeo and Juliet, forbidden love. And I don't want to give too much away, but it's been really popular. What I really love about these is it's very current. Like, it has very modern recently. And so they have this little girl, and she's the only one that is a mix of the winged people and the people with the horns on her head. This woman here, this is also for mature audience as well, so there's some nudity in some parts, but it's just for the story and just for the drama of it. This is more traditional with little squares, but they do go outside the box sometimes with full spread illustrations. illustrations. Like this one. And I got hooked on it. There's this really neat character. I don't think he makes an appearance in this one. No, I don't see him. Oh, this girl is cool. She's the babysitter. She's a ghost. See if he's in the other book. It's this big cat. It looks like a hairless cat, like a house cat, but he's the size of a tiger, and he's this one man's companion. The only thing the cat can say is liar, when it can tell that someone's lying. T-shirts that have the cat's face and just his liar on it. It's really awesome character. This one, the tape is a little stuck. More chapters than this one that's current right now. Let me see if I can find the cat for you. I'm pretty sure he's in the second song. Maybe not. Yeah, the couple, they just have a really cool relationship. Sometimes they show images on the TVs for what these guys are thinking. This is Pocket Raccoon and Groot. This is by Marvel. I really love Groot. I think he's super cute. Documentary on Amazon about the history of Legos. It was really neat. If you like documentaries. So this is kind of your standard action comic. It was cute. I enjoyed it. I'm not like hooked on it like Saga or Sandman. Leaf through it a little. It's pretty wild. His character is great in the movie. I love any movie where all these heinous and ridiculous things are happening, but the main character just keeps his cool and just cracks jokes the whole time. It's a good message. Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on in here too much. I remember I had a weird dream about Big Trouble in Little China. Pretty hard. And it's called Flight. There's 8 of these books. It's a really cool house. I can only assume that there's a chimney action going on here. And like that they have a little crow's nest and there's a little robot. Robots here. They're watering the flowers. I'm not sure if this is a robot. Came there on that big bird, gets all saddled up. This robot, I'm not sure what he's doing. Some little mushrooms growing over there. This illustration is not in the book. So, it's just left to our imaginations. It's gorgeous. See the waterfall back here. I never noticed that their front yard has this little stream. You can go over the little bridge to the inside. It's gorgeous. I'll draw a bridge. These robots have a good life. Alright, so I marked some stories to show you. This has a collection of all different comics. This first story. Any words. It's all illustrations. It's called Underworld. So it starts out, there's this cute little fox, and then you see that what he's looking at. This beautiful yellow butterfly. Then you see that there's a lot of butterflies. Then you see that there's a whole sky. Over, and he goes face to face with the little fox. So we already have an affection for our protagonist here. He's an approachable little guy. So he goes to follow the butterflies, I think, or maybe he's just watching them, but he's cautious. Yeah, he's just watching. Flying away in a row. And there he is. Oh yeah, I brought the magnifying glass here. There he is. Ooh. mushroom in the corner there. Here he goes. To look in the hole. And then we're inside the hole. So you see first. Oh. The butterfly is coming into the cave. Then you see our little friend the fox falling through. Weird. See the expression that he's scared, and you see this big praying mantis creature come down with a big creepy tongue, and the little fox is yelling, and it looks like the tongue went all the way to the alien's shirt there. She does not like it, and the fox does not like to see her upset. Broken two-beat tongue thing. And the praying mantis looks first shocked, then angry. And the little fox has a little standoff with them. Then the fox is scared. He runs off. The praying mantis comes for him. Pretty terrifying, actually. And he's bouncing through the crystal. Keep trying to get behind crystals, but the big brain man, this guy, spots him. What is going on underneath the ground? And oh no, you get a close-up look of the brain man. She's stuck to the pole. And you see the rest of her friends, or her neighbors, her ship crew, not sure, come up and they go to untie her. It looks like her husband comes over, hugs her. They're holding hands, and oh, they see that the little fox, he sacrificed himself to slay the evil praying mantis guy. And there's a woman there looking at it all. Looks like her husband goes over and collects him. Oh, I think there was her husband before he saw it. So he goes over, picks the fox up, walks through some more of the building. I don't know if it's maybe their underground spaceship or what. But he puts them on some sort of altar. And these little wires come down from the ceiling or the wall. They plug into them. From the ceiling off into the altar, all these wires off to electricity. The little alien husband praying. This is above ground. Another planet the whole time, and there's an alien fox and alien butterflies. But so it shoots out and then bounces and it lands. Just a little purple egg, dark purple spots on it. Yeah, they have two moons. Night and it's day and it's fall. That's big storm. You see all the wind, all the snow falling. So seasons pass and then it's spring again. That's a cool little alien flower over there. All the butterflies are back. And what do you see come from the egg? You see this little shard, and then poof, pops open. Our little hero, the fox, and now he's a little uni-fox. He has a crystal unicorn. He looks a little confused. So those alien people thanked him by bringing him back. This one is called The Rescue by Phil Craven. It starts out, there's a little boy leaping through the air somewhere in the woods. You can see the motion that he jumped from this rock. Boom, onto that log there. And it seems like he's being chased by this big lizard. That is a weird type of guy. And so the big monster looking guy. I guess it's more, I'll call him a dinosaur. The big dinosaur guy crushes the log. The little kid's running really fast. The little boy grabs a stick and he threatens him with the stick. And the dinosaur comes, looks like he's kind of just saying, rah. Or something, and the little boy points, and the dinosaur is suddenly scared. You see the dinosaur run off, and then off in the distance, you see hunters, and you get an aerial shot of the hunters running towards them, but they've already moved their way into the foliage. Silhouettes of the hunters or angry mob. They're splashing through some kind of river. I see a little boy looking down. Oh, focus. Here we go, that's probably better. And then you see the tree start to wiggle. And then you see it start to wiggle a lot. And then it starts to take shape back to the dinosaur guy. So, I don't know what he is. Shapeshifter. So, because the little boy gave him the stick to eat, he could turn into whatever is in his mouth. And he turned into a big tree to hide. Then we see, them with their guard up, that they hear something. And very unfortunately, they must have been a hunter that stayed behind. Frames, there's a shot, and it looks like he got hit, or he's just scared. And we see the rest of the hunters there because they hear the shot ring out. Okay, so it was just a dart. Oh, it hurt. The dart gun, and the little boy's trying to get it out, and the rest of the hunters are coming. The dinosaur guy's very scared, and he sees the hunters approaching, and he fights them off, grabs a big log, and little boy is like, yo, stop it, that's my friend, don't shoot, don't do it. And it seems that the tranquilizer gun is starting to kick in. Gets dizzy, and the little boy is very concerned he's about to fall. Oh my goodness, what are they gonna do? eyes or a guy makes a funny face, and then instantly turns into a big boulder. Yeah, the little boy hugs the boulder, or pushes him actually, off a cliff. The boulder falls and rolls down to what I hope is safety. So the boulder's at the bottom of the cliff, and we see the boy here run off to the woods, and there is the back of the hunter's head with the boulder at the bottom of the cliff. Try to shoot the Dinosaur Man once he transforms back. Or he's taking aim. He didn't shoot yet. So he's taking aim. I said, little boy, reach out. And he distracts him to shoot off into the sky instead of shooting off at the boulder. Now, what's interesting here is this little boy's shirt here is orange, and there's nothing wrong with his hands. And suddenly, he's wearing a white shirt, and there's something wrong with his hands suddenly, but we didn't see anything go down. And this guy's making a derpy face, and all these jerks are coming by to see what's wrong with the little kid. So they're seeing why he has a bandage on him, if he's okay, and they carry him off with their angry pitchfork. And then there's just a moment to look over the forest, and we see that in the forest there, shooken up, and he's marching along, and then we see the little boy again running after him. So now we know that this is not the little boy, that he had some kind of trick where he morphed the rock that was next to him. Happens right here. He morphs himself, I believe, from that rock there. So the little boy runs off, but he creates this mirage from the rock. So then they're reunited, and the little boy turns around, holding his hand to see if anybody's there. Then we see the little boy start to metamorphose, and we see, oh, you don't need it for this, we see that all along the little boy was the dinosaur guy's father. Well, there's a man that was older than him. We can only assume that it's his father, and he's consoling him because he's really shooken up and scared from the horrible experience. And the last frame, we see them join. It's a little dark in the woods there. We see them join with the rest of their colony, or their neighbors, whoever. And they're safe again. Cartoons. Of course, no humans ever see their wonderful artistry. Of course, the Sirius was there.
"This will not do,"
said the Cumulus.
"Clouds were not meant to show off."
The Stratus agreed.
"He's not light and fluffy like us. He's weird."
Nimbus immediately went into action. Chew! Rained right on the little train. But the spunky cloud morphed into a fantastic recreation of Noah's Ark. The growing crowd was amused. The Sirius took over.
"I'll distract the audience."
Into a mosh pit of excitement. Astratus moved in.
"Enough of this playing around. I'll scatter this upstart to oblivion."
But the ever imaginative cloud displayed the incredible likeness of the cyclone scene from The Wizard of Oz. There it is, the farmhouse and Dorothy. Actually. where the two biggest cumulus clouds squeezed the life out of him. This was not something they enjoyed. Well, maybe a little. The people drifted away now that the sky was empty and boring. But if you ever find yourself in a certain part of the desert, see a mirage, it just might be the vapor of that little rebel cloud. The end. This is beautiful.